Engineering properties of the rocks. The lecture which is on this topic contains introduction, physical properties of rocks, method of determining rock properties, geological characteristics of rock, general characteristics of rock, modulus properties of flexible strength, elastic properties of rocks, and seven engineering uses of rock, and last the conclusion of this topic. The main objective of this lesson understand the improvement of physical properties of rock and their determination of geological characteristic, general characteristics, modulus properties of rock, building stones and their occurrences. What is the role of engineer? The first one, introduction. Engineering properties of rocks is collect nomenclature which includes such properties of rocks that are relevant engineering applications. After the extraction of the natural beds and without extraction, that is in situ conditions. Then the first in said includes all properties in which rock must have tested for selection of material for construction such as building stones. So these are the introduction. Then laboratory testing is also important. Rock mass properties also, visual examination is important. Then physical properties of rocks. What are the physical factor? The most engineering application rock is used building stones. A building stone may be defined a rock that can be safely used as rough units as a properly cut and shaped, dressed and block or slop, slab, common sheet and different situation engineering construction. The following physical properties considered to be important for the rock to be used building material. The first one, crushing strength. It is termed to compressive strength of the stone and which is expressed by the simple method as follows. C0 is equal to P upon A, that is the compressive strength, load at failure and area of the cross section. The determination of compressive strength of the building or stone involves making the standard state specimens. Then crushing strength of the rock depends the number of factors such as mode of formation, composition, texture and structure of rock, moisture content and extent weathering is already suffered. Igneous rock share crystalline rock. They are compact and characterized by interlocking in their structure and uniform in structure. These rocks possess very high crushing strength and compared to sedimentary and metamorphic rock. The sedimentary and metamorphic rock presents in the plain weakness along the bedding planes. Foliation and schistosity and cleavage gently affects the compressive strength both the direction and magnitude. The sandstone may show very low crushing strength. When the load is parallel to the bedding plane, then loaded perpendicular to the same structure, expect sandstone quartzite may other sedimentary and metamorphic rocks are composed of clay, calcareous material and hydrated silicates. Crushing strength of a common type of building stones are generally higher than loads that they are supposed to withstand and ordinary types of building constructions. These are the some crushing strength expressed in kg per centimeter square. Dolerite is equal to 1500 to 3500, basalt 1500 to 3500, in quartzite metamorphic rock 1500 to 3000, granite 1000 to 2500, marble is 700 to 2000. These are the strength. During few years, thousands of tests have been made to classify the rocks on the basis of uniaxial compressive strength in grades. The following classification proposed Deary and Miller has been found useful. These are the uniaxial compressive strength. A very high strength, first A, more than 2240 High strength 1122 2250 kg per centimeter square. Medium strength 500 to 100 1120. Low strength 200 to 500. Very low strength is less than 200. Transverse strengths. It is defined as the capacity of sandstones withstand bending loads. Such loads as only relatively involve the situations where the stones are commonly used. So it is a relationship of modulus versus transverse strength. The R is equal to, that is the modulus of rupture is equal to weight of the sample breaks upon length of the specimen.